At least one person is confirmed dead as Typhoon Nanmadol unleashes strong winds and record rainfall in Japan. The storm bore down on Japan's southernmost island of Kyushu on Sunday. State media reports a man was killed in the island's Miyazaki Prefecture after being trapped in his car, submerged in a flooded river. Close to 70 were injured, while 340,000 households were without power. Nanmadol has also disrupted public transport and has forced manufacturers to halt operations. Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida has delayed his trip to New York for the United Nations General Assembly until Tuesday to monitor the storm's impact. Nanmadol is seen as one of the strongest storms to hit Japan in years. A magnitude 6.8 quake strikes southeastern Taiwan on Sunday. Taiwan's National Fire Agency said one person was killed by falling machinery at a cement factory in Yuli, which lies close to the epicenter. At least three buildings in the town also collapsed. The Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology, meanwhile, said there was no tsunami threat to the Philippines following that quake. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. now in the U.S. for a six-day working visit. Pia Gutierrez reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is now in the United States for a landmark six-day working visit, which marks his first engagement with the United Nations as Philippine president and his return to the country after several decades. His first stop for today, a meeting with members of the Filipino community at the New Jersey Performing Arts Center. About 1,000 Filipinos welcomed the president, who arrived with his wife, First Lady Liza Araneta Marcos, son Ilocos Representative Sandro Marcos, and members of his cabinet at the Newark Liberty International Airport shortly before 12 noon today. Many of the attendees came from nearby East Coast cities, with some even coming as far as Canada. In his speech, the president could not hide his excitement to be back in the United States, particularly in New York, where he said he had not been able to visit for 25 years. He noted New York is a special place for him, as the city was where him and his wife first met. The president will, of course, be spending the rest of his visit in New York starting tonight. And the president also took time to thank Filipinos in the United States for supporting him during the 2022 elections, noting that he won here despite not being able to physically campaign in the United States. Marcos Jr. also assured the Filipino community here that his administration's priorities are geared towards economic development to make sure that no Filipino will soon be forced to work outside the country.
I would like to pay tribute to all of you and the rest, to the almost 4.5 million Filipinos here in the United States, for the role you play and will continue to play in advancing the interests of the Philippines and the Filipino people here in this part of the world. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Kayo po ang nagdadala ng dangal sa ating bansa.
Aside from Filipinos here, the president says he is scheduled to hold several meetings with business leaders and organizations to hopefully attract investments in the Philippines. He's also expected to hold bilateral talks with a number of world leaders who will also attend the United Nations General Assembly. The highlight of his visit will be his speech during the UN high-level general debate of the UNGA that will happen on Tuesday afternoon. That's early morning Wednesday in the Philippines. The speech will be around 15 minutes, and the president is expected to articulate his administration's priorities, which include climate change, the rule of law, food security, as well as his administration's pandemic recovery plans.
The UN is where the countries of the world congregate to discuss the most pressing challenges facing our people. Thus, it is important for us to participate in the General Assembly and to make certain that our voice is heard. I will be delivering our national statement on the 20th of September, in which I will outline our expectations of the United Nations and the work ahead, the role our country will play, and our contributions to strengthening the international system. Reaffirm the country's commitment to the ideals of the UN citing its contributions to peaceful settlement of disputes and of international law, and highlighting the importance of the UN in fostering international dialogue and cooperation.